Welcome back to the Story of Liberty. Well, you heard the name Sir William Wallace. You've seen him in the movie Braveheart, portrayed by Mel Gibson. Sir William was a Scottish knight who became one of the main leaders during the War of Independence in Scotland. Sir William would not stand back and watch his countrymen pillaged and murdered by the English. He must have had military knowledge because the Battle of Stirling Bridge was brilliant. On September 11th in 1297, Wallace led an army. They were vastly outnumbered, but the Scottish army routed the English army. An English army that had 3,000 cavalry and 8,000 to 10,000 infantry met disaster as they crossed over to the north side of the river. The narrow bridge prevented many of the English soldiers from crossing together, possibly as few as 3 men abreast. And so while the English crossed, the Scots held back half of them and had them killed as quickly as they could cross. The infantry was also sunk in the mud as they did get across. And the Scots, led by William Wallace, defeated the English soldiers, so they had to retreat. Under the overwhelming weight of the bridge, at one point the bridge collapsed and many English soldiers drowned. This victory was significant and it boosted the confidence of the Scottish army. Later on, we know that William decided to resign as the guardian of Scotland in favor of Robert the Bruce, who led Scotland into the future. So much that in 1320, the Declaration of Aberoth was made. This was a prerequisite to our own Declaration of Independence. And here's what it says. As long as but 100 of us remain alive, never will we on any conditions be brought under English rule. It is in truth not for glory, nor riches, nor honors that we are fighting, but for freedom, for that alone which no honest man gives up, but with life itself. You might remember the movie. In the beginning of that battle at Stirling Bridge, when William Wallace says, "How many of you would trade all the days from this day till then to have one chance, just one chance, to come back here and tell the English they may take our lives, but they will never take our liberty?"